Okay, well, I had a video, I had a vlog. I think what I have to do is I have to hit the pause button and then hit the stop button. Every time this computer, every time this phone messes up a video, it makes me mad. Y'all just don't know how mad it makes me. I can't destroy the phone. I gotta have a phone. But I guarantee you, the people that manufactured this phone, the people that wrote the software for this phone, I wish I could meet them face to face and give them the cussing they deserve. Because there's absolutely no reason, no reason whatsoever that you got to lose a video because you didn't hit two or three buttons. If you hit the stop button, then you should save the video. Why can't a programmer not do that? I don't understand that. It's simple. It's a line of code. It's all it is. It's a line of code. But for some damn reason, fucking drunk-ass fucking programmers decided, hey, you know what? We ain't gonna design this phone right. Okay, little rant over. On to the video that I have to redo. This is the pink, I think it's super pink moon. It's supposed to be the brightest moon of 2020. Anyway, that's what I came out here to make a video about, was this bright moon. It doesn't look that bright on the camera. I could zoom into it about four, and you can see the outline of the moon, which is a lot better than cell phone cameras used to do, but it's not a low light camera. It doesn't do real good. But like I said, I think what I have to do is I have to hit the pause button and then hit the stop button. Otherwise, it just, the phone says, oh no, you hit the wrong button. You didn't hit it right. We got to destroy your video. So, okay, they destroyed my video. Like I said, I wish I could meet the programmer so I could cuss him out. But for the most part, other than having a stupid phone that isn't programmed right, okay, let's just live with that. If there's programmers watching my video, which there's not, there's no programmers that give a rat's ass if I'm happy or not. But I am really, really glad to be out of the country. I can wake up. There's things to do here. I'm working on several different projects. Once we get out from under this pandemic that we're under, once the country finds something else, once the media finds something else to talk about, and they decide to let us up and let us move around freely, then I can actively start looking for work. That's what I'm going to be doing. Allegedly, we're supposed to be getting a check, like $1,200 check. Damn, this cat scared the crap out of me. Can you see the cat? I wonder if it'll let me pick it up. Probably not. Let me pick you up. Oh, yeah. Yeah, y'all can't see the cat. Hi. I love cats. Anyway, back to the supermoon. It rubbed against my leg and scared the wits out of me. But, anyway, we get out from under this thing where we're not locked down and we can run around again. And I can actively start looking for work because, honestly, if you go to the job bank, the official government job bank, there's no job listings. There's nothing happening. It's dead. Okay. And as bad as this virus is, and as bad as it can be, I still got to live, you know, and I still got things I want to do, and I still got bills I want to pay, and I still got stuff I want to do. You know, I've got, all my life is still in Houston. It's in a storage shed, you know. Everything that I'm doing, I'm paying my storage bill, my phone, all that stuff is being paid for by somebody else, you know. I'm 57 years old. Living on somebody else's dime just isn't my cup of tea. Sure, I'm getting up and I'm moving around. I mean, I'm feeding the dogs and the cats and, you know, I'm piddling around doing stuff, you know. But I'm still living on somebody else's dime. Somebody else is going to work and making a dollar, and I'm living on that dollar. You know, and I'm trying to do the best I can not to spend no more money than necessary, you know. But thing is like my pawn tickets, they're not going to just go away. You know, they're not going to put them on hold until I get a job. You know, that's not the nature of their business. It's just the way it is. I've got to figure out a way to get that stuff here or watch it leave, you know, just lose it. I think most of it's okay to May, but this is April. So everybody keeps saying, oh, stay home, don't get sick, you know, don't go out, you know, don't spread the virus. Okay, well, great, I'm staying home. I'm not getting sick. But I'm losing everything I own because I can't work. So, I know that that's not as important as staying well. So, anyway, I'm going to try to hit the right buttons this time and not lose this video.